Hi everyone, I'm Shrutinita Roy and I was born and brought up in Kolkata since 1997. Now Kolkata, formerly known as Calcutta, was a city developed by the British East India Company during the 18th and 19th centuries, which led to a dense population growth of European people during the 1800s in here, which led of many churches and cathedrals to serve the purpose of their religion. Show you one such cathedral, which is not only the largest cathedral of Kolkata but also the first Episcopal Church of Asia, which is none other than the St. Paul's Cathedral. This church is located adjacent to Birla Planetarium, Academy of Fine Arts and Robindra Sadan Complex. You can take direct bus from Howrah or Shialdah station, or you can also take the metro and get down at Robindra Sadan or Moidan metro station and walk your way from there till here. The nearest airport is the Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose International Airport. Now, St. Paul's Cathedral is such a cathedral of Anglican background, which is actually the seat of the Diocese of Calcutta. It was built completely in the year 1847. It was built to replace St. John's Church, which had become too small for Calcutta's increasing European community. Gothic revival style by mixing modern constructional elements like an iron framework was included. It has a chancel, a sanctuary, a chapel, and a 201 feet tall spire. Let's go inside the cathedral hall. When approaching through the main entrance, we'll see the east window, which had original stained glass, was destroyed by a cyclone in 1964. It was replaced with a new one in 1968. The roof of the cathedral is in the shape of a shallow curve, arching over iron trusses decorated with Gothic tracery. It was the largest span when built. The hall of the cathedral is built spaciously without any aisle on its flanks. The materials used in the construction of the cathedral consisted of special bricks, light in weight and with good compression strength. The dressed stones were Chunar stones. The external and internal surfaces of the cathedral were plastered with fine chunam, that is lime plaster, in form of secco. But during the 1897 and the 1934 earthquakes, the cathedral suffered a severe damage and its steeple tower collapsed, after which it was reconstructed in a revised architectural style, which is called the Indo-Gothic style, and the tower was constructed after that. The cathedral's interior has a display of many plastic art forms and memorabilia. There is an episcopal throne on the southern flank of the altar and a decorative reredo or wall on its backside dated to 1879. It has carvings of episodes related to the life of St. Paul's, the Annunciation, the Adoration of the Magi and the flight into Egypt, all the works of Sir Arthur Blomfield. The parish hall within the premises of the cathedral is a venue for holding social functions. The eastern wall in the cathedral has paintings of life of St. Paul's painted by Blomfield in 1886. Also notable is the font with its sculpture of Bishop Heber in a kneeling posture. The cathedral's organ with 41 stops made by Henry Willis and Sons of London is still in use. The new design of the cathedral complex included a library on the western porch and a place for keeping plastic art forms and memorabilia. The cathedral is well maintained in a serene and peaceful atmosphere. People from all religious denominations can visit the cathedral and service is held regularly. And Christmas is a special occasion where large number of people assemble to join in the festivities. Other than that, different school children also come here to visit during the winter. If a tourist is visiting Kolkata, they should never miss this place.